Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to thank you all for coming to the fourth hearing on this committee on proposed Senate Resolution Number 518 and other recent cases of other political assassinations. Allow me to say for the record that the hearing we had last April 19 was without a doubt one of the most gripping that I have ever had the privilege of holding. Gripping, thrilling, but sadly, and for the most part, for the wrong and unjust reasons. Gusto ko pong iparating sa lahat ng ating mga kababayan na nakikinig at nagmumonitor, Negrense man o hindi, ang ganda po ng probinsya ng Negros Oriental, mapakabundukan man o karagatan, hindi po natin maipagkakaila kung gaano kayaman ang probinsyang ito. This is precisely why it is so heartbreaking to know that a place as beautiful as Negros Oriental could be enveloped with such darkness, killings, land grabbings, illegal gambling, and countless allegations of violence, many of them political in nature. Number one, Mayor Janice Digamos' opening statement nung second hearing. Nabanggit dito, Provincial Director DNR mentioned as fearful of the TVCs. Takot ka doon sa mga TVCs. Kaya yung mga decision-making mo doon ay medyo nag-aalangan ka. Can you explain that to us? You have the floor.
Thank you, Your Honor, for giving me the opportunity. I myself have been questioning the statement and why should I be afraid of anyone? As I was been working with the government for the last 33 years, I was just working on what is mandated to my job. And I don't interfere. Collegial lang among mga relationship with all the previous and current leaders. And when it was mentioned that our decisions at the DNR are gone by politics and we are afraid, wala man siguro, Your Honor. We have a very cordial relationship with both leadership sa among probinsya. Wala naman kaming nakuan, nagtrabaho lang kami, sir.
In short. Baka ngayon ka lang, wala nang takot ha, pero noon takot
wala
ka.
Wala naman, sir.
Wala.
Although both parties tumatawag yan sa mga atin to kuan ng mga request, pero sabihin na meron akong takot, wala naman siguro.
Kayo, kaya nga kayo pinatawag dito, ikaw, pati yung DAR, dahil sa issues ng land grabbing at may namamatay sa issue sa land, eh, kayo naman talaga ang kuan dyan, concerned
yes,
dyan, ha?
Sir.
But si Mayor Digamo.
I would like to, Mr. Chair, to make some clarification regarding the Amparita case. Several attempts were made by Madam Amparita to ask CENRO office headed by Sir Vernov Grifalde regarding its status with the land dispute between Congressman Arnie Teves, Amparita Ihan, and that of my son, who have been land grabbed by the Teveses. And I think after two letters, my secretary who went there to bring the letter was told, sketch lang ang kayang ibigay nila. But as to its response, they were not able to give an accurate detail of how it was at this point in time, considering that it has been 2 or 3 years. It has been 3 years already that the investigation of as to its who should be the person to, because you cannot own forestal land, who you should consider to be the occupant have not been resolved yet up to these days. And his office refused to give an answer to a query that we have made through writing for several times also already.
Thank you. Can you respond to that, Engineer Grifaldi?
Can I ask a specific location of that complaint, Your Honor, sa Chicho Nabalabag?
Sa Nabalabag, yes.
Sa Tontapad, sa...
You know that very well. We have talked about
I'm not aware that issue started way back in 2019. I became I reported in Negros Oriental from Cebu in 2020 September. So although I inherited the issue from the previous Senro Kanda and Senro Efren, there was a conflict between two parties, between Governor Digamo first and Congressman Tevez. And there was an investigation that both parties purchased the claims from different persons, from Mr. Villaflores on the side of the Digamo and Mr. Lawrence Tevez on the side of Congressman Tevez. Then there was an overlap when it was surveyed based on the result of the survey by both parties. And the overlap was about 3,000 meters, Your Honor. And then in May 24, 2021, there was a joint Regional Peace and Order Council meeting chaired by no less than former President Rodrigo Duterte. It was held in Dumaguete City. And this same issue was presented during that meeting. Although we were outside of the venue, it was shown in the television big screen outside the venue, the proceeding of that meeting, and there was an order with the recommendation of the former DNR Secretary Roy Simato that the area in conflict within the timberland to de-escalate, both parties to de-escalate and disengage in the area or else the military will take over. That was the order, sir, during that meeting in Dumaguete for the regional, Joint Regional Peace and Order Council. So after that meeting, there were policemen who visited our office and they inspected the area and it was mentioned that this and this and that. Based on the former preliminary investigation, and of course, everything was obeyed because it was the order of the president. And then comes another entry, sumasali, sir, meaning to say a claimant again come out of the blue, and then that was Ma'am Impe Amparita Ihan, who again was here during the third hearing, that stating that he was a claimant. Now, there were subsequent visitation to her place conducted by Senro Dumaguete, that in July 2020, she was visited at her place, and his the statement was she will not apply, but she was claiming that same lot, which was already in conflict between the governor and the congressman, she appealed po siya. So tatlo na sila, bali, sa area. But that's why we will request during the presentation of Ma'am Ihan here in the Senate, if possible, next week with the assistance of the local government unit, we can conduct investigation. We will create a team for that. And then she will guide the team saan ang exact location na sinasabi niya na merong nakuha ng area. And last September 19, 2021, Your Honor, a team from the DNR, there was a report from the Senro Dumaguete that they visited Mrs. Amparita Ihan at her residence together with his brother, with her brother, ma'am. And they were invited by the DNR personnel to visit the DNR Central Office and to bring with them a documentation to show proof of his of her claim of diarrhea. Pero wala mang nagkuhan, sir. And then, ngayon, meron ng order sa May na de-escalate diarrhea, disengage. So, siguro, kung mag-apply si Ma'am Ihan for a tenure from the DNR, we can assist if kung pwede